Match game 74, production number 0284, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Charlie Brill, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joyce Boulevard, Richard Dawson, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Now, friends, we are gathered here.
Hello there.
Hi. Hello, ciao, ciao.
Ciao.
Come va?
Va bene, grazie.
Bene, grazie.
Yeah. Have you met my sister?
Ich will nicht stehen.
Oh, I see. You have a question. What is it?
What? Don't you like his patriotic shirt?
Charles, you're wearing red, white, and blue with stars and stripes and all that?
Yes, for two reasons.
Yes?
To remind everyone we still have a wonderful country. And besides that, I'm running out of shirts.
Our two players here, Silvana Caballero and Darcy Bell. How are you, ladies? Silvana's a current champ. She's won $1,050, and she's very happy about that, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
And your husband is very happy about that?
He's happier than I am, probably.
He's happier than you? Darcy, would you want to tell us a little bit about yourself again before we begin?
I'm from West Covina. I have a little boy, 15 months old. I'm married.
Okay.
And I teach.
That's enough. You don't have to tell me anymore. You're married, right? Oh, no. Tell me more. I'm only kidding.
And I am a swim instructor.
That's right. And you teach people of all ages to swim.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll begin this game right after we have a message for you, America. So pay attention. I have to tell you what went on just a moment ago. The lady down in the studio audience says, how come they always have more women contestants than men? I said, well, it's hard to find good men for this show. We're always looking for good men. She says, me too. All right, ladies, are you ready? Here we go. Darcy, would you please make a selection?
A, please.
A. New game everybody plays. The psychiatrist said to his secretary, please don't talk about fruit salads in front of my next patient. He thinks he's a blank. Psychiatrist speaking to his secretary. Please don't talk about fruit salads in front of my next patient. He thinks he's a blank. Now, Darcy will think about that as you are thinking about it.
Hooray for the red, white, and blue.
Okay, you finished, Brett.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, Darcy, the psychiatrist said to his secretary, please don't talk about fruit salads in front of my next patient. He thinks he's a blank.
A peach?
A peach? Well, he was a peach, but what did he think? No, I'm only kidding. No, he said a peach there. Charlie?
He was a peach to her, honey, but he's a banana to me.
I see. Okay. Brett?
Well, there's so many fruits in the world, you don't know where to turn.
Yeah.
I said pineapple.
Okay.
No.
You missed a good joke. Banana!
Banana! All right, Joyce. I'm not going to ask him because I think I know what he's going to say. So you go on with it here now.
Hurry up,
we all know the same person. It's a banana.
Banana. Banana seems to be the answer. I would have said strawberry, something like that. What
yeah,
did you,
you
say?
Would.
Yeah.
What was the question?
Well, please don't talk about fruit salads in front of my next patient. He thinks he's a...
A fruit.
A fruit.
No name given.
Okay. What did you
say? One day's a strawberry.
What did I say?
Yes, what did you say?
What did I say?
Peach is the answer.
Banana.
You said banana. All right.
Oh.
So you had lots of bananas and all that, but no peaches there. Yes, we have no bananas. Harriet said...
I wasn't talking.
I watch TV commercials very closely, and I've discovered... that the tidy bowl man is really blank. Harriet said that. She said, Silvana. You know who the Tidy Bowl, you know about the Tidy Bowl and all that? Okay. Mm-hmm. Harriet said, I watch TV commercials very closely, and I've discovered that the Tidy Bowl man is really blank. Leave him alone. Is this lady molesting you, sir?
I'm a new guy.
Yeah, that's right.
Remember how I saved you?
That's right. Okay. Everybody's ready, Silvana.
Everybody's ready.
Harriet said, I watch TV commercials very closely, and I've discovered that the Tidy Bowl man is really...
clean?
Really clean. If you're going to groan, let's have it all in unison.
That's a peach of an answer.
That's a peach of an answer. She said the Tidy Bowl man is really clean, Charlie.
I heard
Charlie.
What she said. He's clean also, but he's also Billy Barty. Little fella.
He's small.
Swims in toilets. Not
okay.
She's talking.
What'd you say, Brett?
I say I'm really Bat Lady.
You're Lady Bat Lady. What's a Bat Lady
I
say?
I said really filthy.
Really filthy. That's the opposite of clean, Charles.
I said he was a dirty old man.
A dirty old man.
Oh.
I watch TV commercials very closely, and I've discovered that the Tidy Bowl man is really... clean is what she said. What did you say?
Oh,
I have the same answer as Charles, the dirty old man, Richard Dawson.
Richard Dawson.
Very good.
Dirty old man, eh?
Well, in that case, I'm flush with success. I happen to know.
Yes.
What's a Tidy Bowl man?
Tell us.
Really is Charles Nelson.
Walking around
doing
up there.
Wonderful job.
Little canoe there.
A little canoe. Well, I know of what I speak. I've had trouble with my Tidy Bowl man today, even.
Oh, no.
Yes.
Really?
Mine is very blue.
Tidy Bowl man is very blue.
He didn't want to go all the way out to the outhouse.
I see. So we have a tight game going here. No score. It's a 0-0 game so far. Two coming up. First, we've got to get a glass of water for me while you watch it. Now, here's the way it is, folks. Finish round one, have no score. We start round two. Darcy Bell, please make a selection.
A, please.
A?
Yeah.
Speak up, Darcy.
A.
She swims so much, she's forgotten how to talk.
Okay.
Can we keep these pens?
Yes, absolutely. If you want that, you may keep it, my dear.
Thank you very much.
Nanook the Eskimo said... I've built a generator for my igloo. I make my own electricity by putting my blank on a treadmill. Did you hear that, Darcy? About Nanook the Eskimo, who built a generator for his igloo. He says, I make my own electricity by putting my blank on a treadmill. Now, you don't have to think too hard about this.
No, I'm not thinking hard, just one of the best answers.
Just take yourself up to the North Pole there.
Okay.
All right, got one, Brett? Okay.
Put in mine.
Joyce.
I can't think of anything.
You're going to end up in the upper tier with the other dingbats.
I don't know
what to do. Please do it once more, because she's a little... She is, she hung up.
She actually came here to vacuum. Do you see that Hoover apron she has on?
I make my own electricity by putting my blank on a treadmill. Do you know what a treadmill is?
Yeah, it's a thing that goes along.
Yeah, well, it's an endless belt, and you walk on it. You see, you move the treadmill.
It's what you've been on, dear, for years.
Up the lanes.
Okay.
Why don't you two finish this in the cocktail lounge?
Okay. All right, that's it. Now, Darcy, Nanook the Eskimo said, I've built a generator for my igloo. I make my own electricity by putting my blank on a treadmill.
My wife.
My wife. See how easy it is? Hello, Charlie.
Hi, honey.
How are you?
Not so good.
Charlie Brill is not so good?
Because I didn't match with that lady.
You didn't?
I didn't.
Did you try?
But I have a nice answer. I hope the audience likes it.
Well, let's see what it is.
You don't match, they don't like it. Really?
Right.
I put my sled dog on
sled
the
sled dog.
God bless you.
That's not
God
bad.
God bless you,
That's
George.
Not
she
bad
liked
at all.
Could Charlie stand for 1 second?
Yes.
Could you just stand?
Surely.
Open fire!
No!
Oh, so rude.
Brett?
It was two choices. There were only two choices. One was wife and one was dogs. And as usual, excuse me.
Oh, Lord, help me this day to keep my mouth shut. I said dog.
All right, Charles, have you got a winner?
Dog team.
Dog team. She's looking for wife. You know, I build her generator for my igloo. I make my own electricity by putting my... she said wife.
She said wife.
On a treadmill. And you said...
Well, his wife was very fat, his husky.
Well, I'm sorry, but we can't do that. He may have been married to a lady who had an avoirdupois problem, but we can't count that as a match, can we, Richard?
Had a what problem, sir?
Avoirdupois, excessive amounts of adipose tissue.
Oh, good. As long as she wasn't fat, I can't stand it. My dear Darcy Bell, allow me.
Oh, thank you, Darcy.
Good answer, wife.
All right, Marcia, we're really rolling now. We're really rolling,
well,
Marcia.
I've not been myself since you breathed in my ear yesterday and toyed with my emotions and my lobe. And I'm happy to have a chance to redeem myself. Wife.
Right. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right, Giovanni, you need 2 to tie, 3 to win. Here we go, everybody plays. Yep. Long John Silver said, well... As you can see, mateys, I'm walking with a bad limp today because my wooden leg is blank. Long John Silver said that. As you can see, mateys, I'm walking with a bad limp today because my wooden leg is blank. Do you know who Long John Silver was, my dear?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you think about that for a moment. And we'll see what the dingbats are doing over here. All right, everybody's ready except Marcia.
How rude of you to bring that up.
All right, Silvana. Long John Silver said, as you can see, mateys, I'm walking with a bad limp today because my wooden leg is...
Broken.
Broken. That's, that'd make him limp a little bit, wouldn't it? And what did you say?
I'm walking with a little limp today because my wooden leg is warped.
Warped. Ben, Brett?
I left mine home. It's gone.
It's gone. I make you limp, too, and lean.
Warped.
I'm sorry, no one's come to my answer yet. How about you?
Have you got an answer?
I got an answer in my head.
Sawed off.
Silvana, you must match the 2 remaining celebrities to stay in the game. Let's see. Her answer is broken. I'm walking with a bad limp today because my wooden leg is broken.
Excuse me. Is a must a match?
Is a must a match.
Otherwise...
Otherwise, va fora.
But I cannot allow that.
No, you cannot allow.
Prego el broccano.
Broccano. Besides, her husband going to punch you in the nose. Now,
don't you, look at me like that.
You're going to get punched in the nose by her husband if you don't match a broken.
Hello. I come to your house and I do windows.
And what is your answer?
My answer?
Yeah.
You don't want to know my answer.
Yes, I want to know your answer.
Well, gosh, it's missing.
Missing, not broken. So Darcy Bell wins the game. So you've got $100, and we're going to say goodbye to Silvana. I guess you're not too unhappy about leaving here.
It's a pleasure.
Because you're going to be leaving here with $1,050. Many thanks for being with us. Silvana Cavallaro.
Ciao.
Okay, now, would you take our picture, please, while the commercial is going on? We'll just pose like this, all right? All right, here we are, friends. Ready to have a go at it here with Darcy Bell? This is her first time, right?
Yes.
You know how it goes?
Yes.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. How do you feel?
I don't know.
You don't know? You feel all right to me. We polled a recent studio audience. Oh, we're not on the mark. You got to stand on the tape down there. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Split blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. And the second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Whom would you like to help you?
Richard.
From whom would
Split
you?
Second.
Split second. Okay, there's one.
Charles.
Charles.
split personality, like you, Sheila.
Split personality, that's two.
Brett.
And Brett.
What about split pea soup?
What about split pea soup?
Awfully good on a cold day.
One order of split pea to go.
BLT on Leto.
All the mail.
All the mail.
So you got split pea soup, split personality, and split second. You may take one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do, Darcy?
Split second.
You want split second? You think that's up there? Under the big one, huh? All right, she says split second is under the big one up there, but we got to start with the little one. So may we see the $100 response. Split personality is one that Charles gave you.
Chuck gave you that one.
Okay, Chuck. Now, we're looking for split second. Here is the $250 response. Split P is the one that Brett gave you. All right, you got
right.
Two out of three, Darcy. This is probably a good omen. Let's all watch together as we reveal the $500 response. Split second. You won the $500, and that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount now. $5,000. That's a lot of money. You've got to match one celebrity headband. Which one will it be now?
Richard.
I'm drunk at home, adjusting the vertical roll. I can't keep them still, darling.
No, the picture keeps jumping there. Okay, would you face me, please? And you get ready to write. Here we go. Peter blank. Peter blank. Okay, $5,000 at stake here. Now, Darcy, would you suggest an answer you think matches Richard's answer? Peter
Rabbit?
You're saying, oh, you don't like that answer?
No.
Two people like it, the rest thinks it rotten.
People laughed at pee.
That's right, they laughed at pea soup. Okay, Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer? She says Peter Rabbit.
I don't know if it's just not my week.
Really?
All I could think was of the other game show and the host, you know,
Peter Marshall. Marshall.
And I thought, why should I plug in?
Would you bring the doctor in, see if we can get her out of this depression now? Okay, now you've got $5,600. Oh. How much you weigh?
I don't know.
I do.
There is the winning card.
You can keep that as a souvenir. And you're still the champ, Darcy. You're going to meet another player right now, so let's bring on Janet Frundell. Okay, Janet, you know Darcy?
Yes, Angie.
Hello, Janet Frundell.
Hello.
Where are you from?
I'm from Venice. I'll tell the best things first. My children, I have a son, Patrick, 13, and a daughter, Summer, who's 4. And I've gone from bartending and managing nightclubs to wrapping bodies.
Wrapping bodies?
I'd like to volunteer.
Yes. My show. Tell us about wrapping bodies.
I'm a figure consultant.
A figure consultant.
And I wrap for overweight.
Oh, you do?
To get it off.
Oh,
well,
I see.
You mean they're alive when you wrap?
Yeah.
Oh, that lets you
off.
Out.
I get it on.
First thing I thought it was Egyptian mummies when she said I wrap bodies. I said, what the heck kind of a weirdo did they get out here? But you're a very lovely lady. You're not a weirdo at all. Now, we found out about Janet Frundell, and we're ready to start another game, but we got to stop everything right now, and we got to pass along these messages to you. I'm sorry to say we've got to go now. We're all going to get together with yards and yards of burlap and wrap her body.
And
see, and
we're throwing
it
in the bay.
That's it.
And
that's
with the,
right.
With the leftovers, you can do mine.
I have to
go. That'll make him look fatter. Where
I'm
you
due up the pole any minute.
You do? Okay. Gene Rayburn Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotton production.